Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Drish, and today in our channel we will be talking about one of the most important person in the film and fashion industry of India. She is a fashion stylist, a costume stylist, and also the fashion director at Vogue India. She is Anita Shroff Adajania. Before jumping into the video, let me tell you who is a stylist. In the simplest of the simplest way, a stylist is a person who designs the visual images that we see in magazines and videos in the film and fashion industry. So coming to Anita Shroff, Anita Shroff Adajania was born in a Parsi family in Mumbai on 25th February 1972. She did her schooling in Mumbai's Bombay International School, and she did her graduation from St. Xavier's, Mumbai, in political science. Her mother wanted her to graduate, so instead of going to a fashion school in which Anita's interests lie, she went to St. Xavier and got her degree in political science. While in college, Anita undertook many modeling assignments which helped her finance her own travels all over the world, and this gave her considerable amount of exposure and became foundation on which her career would be based. Anita was obsessed with fashion from a very young age. Her formative years were spent under the influence of her grandparents. Her grandpa had a bespoke tailoring shop in South Bombay, where she heard her grandpa tell his customers how to dress, and this had a big influence in her head. And the concept of styling and to tell people what to wear, what not to wear, and the fittings was starting to seed in her mind, and this became her base for her coming year. Also, her grandmother used to embroider her clothes and used to visit the seamstress once a week, so it was another way of influencing her. Again, while in college, she used to spend all her pocket money in magazines like Vogue and Seventeen, and also would ask her father to bring back magazines like Harper's Bazaar, Vogue, Queen from London, and she used to cut those fashion editorials or any such fashion photos and put them in her file. And she didn't really know why was she doing that, but now she says in her interviews that it comes full circle of why she used to do that. Anita Shroff has a sister named Shehrazad Shroff, who was a former model and an actress. And Anita Shroff Adajania got married to Homi Adajania in 2002, who is an Indian filmmaker, and the couple have two sons, Zain Adajania and Zireh Adajania. Anita Shroff has three high-profile careers in styling in three different industries: publishing, advertising, and cinema. As a fashion director of Vogue India in the publishing industry, as a commercial stylist in the advertising industry, and as a top costume stylist in Bollywood in the cinemas. According to Business of Fashion, Anita Shroff Adajania walks in a powerful intersection in a country where Bollywood stars are the most bankable way to sell fashion magazines and consumer products. Vogue gives her credibility, Bollywood gives her clout, and advertising gives her cash. It's hard to think of a smarter formula. Anita Shroff Adajania discovered or invented a non-existing career and helped it grow and develop. Once, Anita Shroff Adajania took part in an arts competition in her school in the category fashion design without knowing what it meant, and somehow she won the competition. She used to be inspired by the way her teacher used to dress, what her teacher is wearing, the shoes, and it is not something that Anita wanted to become a stylist from the very beginning, and she knew it that she wanted to do this. At one point, she wanted to become an air hostess because she wanted to travel across the world. And another point, she wanted to become a hairdresser, for which she even wanted to go to London to pursue her career. And again, another point, she wanted to become a photographer. After college, Anita's first job was at production with filmmaker Mahesh Mathai, and she soon realized that her interest doesn't lay in production but in the costumes and sets. So she decided to take a traveling break, and this traveling break is an iconic traveling break because this is the first turning point for Anita. So this traveling break is about 1995, and Anita Shroff Adajania and Karan Johar were classmates. The film was Dilwale Dulhania Le Jayenge, and he was the assistant director of the film. And for the movie, Karan Johar asked Anita Shroff to help him cast some side actors for the movie. And in that process, Anita Shroff Adajania became one of the members, and she appeared in the film. This is the work/traveling break she took to go to London and shoot the film. While traveling, she would observe people's style of dressing. In this process, she also got to work with the biggest costume designers of that time, Manish Malhotra. When she returned from her work holiday shooting from the film in London, she begged an offer to work with the international fashion magazine, Elle. There were no major international fashion magazines in India when Elle launched in India in 1996. This was her second major break in the industry when she was appointed as the junior fashion editor for the magazine. From shooting the very first cover, her edits have catered to a growing market of savvy and influential people. By then, one of the country's most original and respected fashion photographer, Farooq Chhotia, hired young Anita Shroff for advertising job, devising a stylist role for her. Anita Shroff's first commercial styling job was for Maybelline, and then she has been styling some of the biggest fashion ad campaign ever since. Anita Shroff tries for costume styling and costume designing started with Rahul Bose's film Everybody Says I'm Fine. The original costume designer for this movie ditched Rahul Bose in the last moment, and Rahul Bose went to Anita Shroff, asked help from her, and that's how they did the movie. After this film, she started styling for other movies, and one such major movie is 2003 Kal Ho Na Ho. In this film, she did a dual role. One, she played a cameo in the movie, and two, she styled the costumes for the songs in the movie. In 2004, Aditya Chopra approached her to do the movie Dhoom, and since then, a steady amount of work went on Anita Shroff's way. Next, in 2005, Anita Shroff styled the first film for her husband, Homi Adajania, Bing Cyrus. 2007 was a significant milestone in Anita Shroff Adajania's career. The international version of Vogue launched in India in 2007, and she landed the job of fashion director at Vogue India. 2006, Anita Shroff Adajania did Dhoom 2, for which she got IFA Best Costume Designer of the Year. In 2008, Anita Shroff Adajania did the movie Crazy 4 and Bhootnath. 2009, she did the movie Love Aajkal, for which she got her second IFA for Best Costume Designer. 2011, she did the movie Ravan, and in 12, she did the movie Players and Cocktail. In 2012, she also became a council member for Vogue Fashion Fund's Awards. 2013, she did the movie Race 2 and Dhoom 3. And by 2013, Anita Shroff kind of became a personal stylist for Deepika Padukone. She styled her for all her events, red carpets and special appearances, even putting her on the September cover for 2013. In 2014, she did the movie Bang Bang and Finding Fanny. In 2015, she did Tamasha and Hero. In 2016, she did the movie Fitur and Ye Dil Hai Mushkil. In 2017, she did Raabta and Half Girlfriend. In 2018, she did the movie Andhadhun, Race 3 and Zero. And in 2019, she did the movie War. And in 2021, she did the movie Suryavanshi, which is in addition to her work in cinema and Vogue. She also takes on celebrity styling on a per outfit basis. It is relatively a new source of income that has grown along with the rise of paparazzi culture in India, red carpet events, especially film awards, and Bollywood style blog. Anita Shroff Adajania has also served as a motivational speaker in different colleges of India. Anita Shroff Adajania runs a styling consultancy in Mumbai, Style Cell. It comprises of Adajania and some of her assistant stylists. Can also be hired for workshops for operative clients, personal makeovers, or helping new designers find their voice. In 2017, she also started her highly popular masterclasses at the Vogue India wedding show, imparting tips on seasonal trends for the brides-to-be. In 2018, her career blossomed with her own celebrity talk show called Feet Up with the Stars. But between the two worlds of cinema and editorial, Anita Shroff core creativity is with Vogue, fashion and editorials. Long before celebrity stylist becomes a profession, Anita Shroff had a successful costume stylist career. At that time, the competition was limited. She had the talent, but at the same time, she also had the Bollywood connections to establish herself as a successful stylist. As a fashion director of Vogue India and creative consultant, Anita Shroff Adajania is one of the leading voices in India's fashion. She wields considerable influence in the fashion industry, from creating looks in Bollywood as well as creating looks in major fashion magazines. With that being said, thank you for watching the video and have a great day.